We have got a special one with Kenny in tonight. We will be looking ahead now to Real Madrid against Liverpool at the weekend, Kenny. Probably the first thing probably we need to look at then. So how do you think they'll line up? Let's have a look at the both 11. How do you think Real Madrid and Liverpool will line up on Saturday?
Yeah, well, this is an absolute dead cert in terms of Liverpool's shape. We've seen this all season. Very rarely, if ever, does Klopp deviate from that. Back four, there's that V-shape in midfield. Jordan Henderson, Wijnaldum, and James Milner because of the injuries there. And the front three, I don't even have to name them. That 4-3-3 formation, that V-shaped in midfield, very rarely changes, Kevin, any real circumstance during the course of a game. And Real Madrid will have prepared this week knowing this is exactly how Liverpool are going to shape up.
One thing on Liverpool, he did change it. I know Solanke went in where Firmino played a bit deeper. Is there any potential where he could go two up front and play Firmino a bit deeper? Or maybe play a diamond shape in midfield? Is there anything like that? Or is that
I couldn't even make an argument. This, for me, is Liverpool's strength. Klopp's been pretty consistent in that we play to our strengths. Teams have to adjust to our style of play, even Real Madrid. And for me, it's the right approach because this is the team shape and the team personnel, which is certainly capable of going and winning this game.
Real Madrid, what do you think on Real then? How do you think they'll go? Because they have changed it a little bit throughout this season. They have gone with a 4-3-3. They've gone 4-5-1 come a real attacking, you know, diamond shape as well, if you want. So he's gone three up front. So how do you think he's going to line up then this weekend?
Well, this is fascinating for me because people generally, they ask us, Kev, obviously do a bit of work in the media, give us a prediction for the game.
Some do, Ken, some do.
But I always say, and it's difficult to say, look, let me see the team sheet. And not only because of the personnel, but in terms of the team shape. Because I feel if Real Madrid line up with this particular formation, with a back four, there's that diamond shape in midfield. Casemiro, we'd expect. Cruz and Modric either side. That's pretty much as a given. And a front two of Ronaldo, potentially Benzema, and one in behind, whether that be Isco or Asensio. Yeah. This, for me, gives Liverpool...
No Bale, because Bale started last weekend. He's in great form. Bale started up front alongside Ronaldo with Isco in the hole in behind.
No, I think it's a shout. I think it's a number you could argue Isco or Asensio on this area of the pitch. Bale as well, for me. Personally speaking, having watched a bit of Bale of late, honestly, saw his goal at the Nou Camp recently.
Yeah.
Absolutely outstanding. Playing with a little bit of a strut again to his game. Just might be hitting a bit of form at the right time. That just might nudge his manager into giving him a start alongside Ronaldo. More than dynamic, more pacey now, more capable attacking the space in behind than Benzema. Certainly his presence there would frighten that Liverpool defence a little bit more than a partnership for me of Benzema and Ronaldo. But you can see the shape, Kev, where the strength is with this diamond shape, always is that central area of the pitch. And you could take that 20 yards up the pitch, the Real Madrid front two, Isco in behind, Cruz and Modric operating in these areas, really asking questions this Liverpool defensive unit, not just the back four. You have to get your fullbacks nice and narrow, that midfield three narrow up, likewise the front three, keep, you know, narrow up because of the quality they have in these central layers, that one-touch combination football. You have to recognise that, respect it and adjust accordingly. But Kev, what I'd say with this formation, this diamond formation, if they did employ it, where it leaves them open, you can almost see it, which are those big swathes of green down the sides where it's possible for Liverpool, not just our wide men, to get an advanced
area. Well, let's have a look at it from the start then. So you're saying out wide is a key area. So Real Madrid obviously have more body centrally.
Yeah. And you have to deal with that. That's not easy because of the quality they have. But Liverpool are organised. They're set up well. They can pinch the ball. They keep a good defensive shape. And eventually they'll fancy their chance, even against Madrid, and nicking the ball. And when they get possession, Kev, this is the way out. Not to play through those Real Madrid numbers, no centrales in the wide areas, which is where their strength is. You have a look at Trent Alexander potentially getting himself into wide areas, doubling up with Salah. Where's that natural winger who's going to go and drop in and track that run? They haven't got one. Madrid will be sending people out from these central midfield areas. Cruz will be coming out.
Playing up there, it's always difficult, I always used to find, Ken, if you're ever playing in a three-man midfield and you had that responsibility, say you're the left side of the three-man midfield, always, you're always getting out to it, aren't you? You never.
That's the problem, Kev. It takes you time. It takes you 2, 3, 4 seconds. And by the time you've done that, Liverpool have already advanced into these areas. Liverpool are 10, 20 yards deep into Real Madrid half before the likes of Cruz can get out and double up with Marcelo over that side of the pitch. As opposed to playing with an orthodox five in midfield, this particular shape that we're talking about.
Yeah, which they have done, of course.
Which they have done traditionally. And for me, is the way they have to go.
If they line up with with a 4-5-1 or 4-3-2, which players are playing in the position then, do you think, then now for Real Madrid?
Well, again, the same for me, of course, Zidane had me thinking head on in terms of paying the utmost respect to Liverpool and the quality which they possess, particularly in these wide areas which you've spoken about, Salah and Mane in particular. I'd be looking for players who can give you a little bit of an attacking threat, who can get up and join in with Ronaldo, who now is playing as a central striker, who can go and join in and link in, but also out of possession, get into a good defensive shape, and who can drop in and do the defensive side as well. So for me, you're looking at kind of Vasquez, you're looking at Asensio, yeah. Isco, possibly at a stretch, Gareth Bale, although he doesn't like doing it. Benzema doesn't like to do it now. He hasn't got the legs to do it. But for me, that Real Madrid shape of a five in midfield, actually replicating what Liverpool are doing. Some people might say, oh, he's blinking there, Zidane. He's playing too much. He's changing to accommodate Liverpool. But I think it's something that he has to do. He has to block these channels, these wide areas where Liverpool get those overloads. Fullbacks Robertson and Trent Alexander-Arnold, you can't give them acres of space because they'll push you back and very quickly Madrid will find themselves defending 10 yards outside their penalty box. So for me, this is key. Tactically, Zidane, he's got it right a lot of times since he's been at Real Madrid. For me, this is the way Real Madrid have to go. Five in midfield with natural width in the team who can drop into a defensive block of five and four when they haven't got the ball. But when they have got the ball, very quickly can get players up in support of Ronaldo, wherever they may be, Bale, Isco, Asensio, and obviously Modric and Cruz just supporting generally in behind. And obviously got Casemiro providing that little bit of a kind of defensive cover in front. That's the way forward for me. If Madrid lined up that way, say regardless of personnel, for me that makes Real Madrid favourites. They go with that diamond shape in midfield.
Which you think they actually will, is that right then?
No, I don't think so. I think he'll go with the five, Kev, but it wouldn't surprise me at all if he went. He goes with that diamond shape in midfield. People look at that and think, well, look at the quality in here. Liverpool in trouble. How are they going to deal with that? And yes, Liverpool would be looking at that thinking, oof, we got a handful here. But also, at the same time, Klopp is saying, yeah, but look. Look where we can get at these down the side. Yeah. In their playing into our hands.
That's where you bring in. You mentioned there Mane and Salah. You mentioned these overlords here. That is what we know that. We know how Marcelo plays. We know how Carvajal, particularly Marcelo. Definitely. Liverpool's strongest side this season has been down the right hand side with Salah. Marcelo will go in advanced positions at times. He will go beyond Mo Salah. He will be playing a bit of the old game with him. Look, let's see what you can do. You're going to come back and mark me. Yeah. Are you going to do that job? So what then? What then happens then? If they're playing with that diamond, Marcelo's pushing on, is obviously the responsibility. You're probably looking at Casemiro to have a bit of responsibility. Does that then play into Liverpool's hands? That you automatically then trying to fire a ball immediately into Salah to get him into a game?
Yeah, but I think what you'll see is because Real Madrid will play the two up front, really, if they play the two up front, they will pin the two centre-halves. And if I was playing right side of centre-half, potentially Bale, Ronaldo up front, I'd be screaming at me full-back. Getting it along, so particularly Lovren, I need cover. Narrow up. You do that, and Marcelo gets himself high up the pitch. It's going to have to be Salah's responsibility to track that run.
Do you make that one then? We've seen it with various people. You make it almost like a one-on-one between Salah and Marcelo, and you're saying, I'll tell you what, then who is good? You've got the full...
Yeah, it would be on a case. That's what Madrid, that would probably be Marcelo's mindset in terms of, well, Salah, as good as he is in the last third of the pitch, I'm going to make him defend in his last third of the pitch for majority of the game. An interesting tactic, of course, if you were to be really brave, when Marcelo gets himself up into those high areas of the pitch, rather than Alexander-Arnold come narrow and expect Salah to track that run, almost become an auxiliary fullback. Do you know what? Lovren, deal with that. Van Dijk, get across. Robinson, narrow up on that
so
side of the
pitch. What
you're
saying there, you're saying Van Dijk Robertson, and Lovren have got the responsibility of a one-on-one. They've got to deal with it one-on-one with your
little
bit of cover with Robertson.
Should be a 3-v-2 there. And Trent Alexander to scream at Salah, no, stay here.
Yeah.
Stay up the pitch. I'll deal with Marcelo here. And any ball we win back in these areas, Salah, have a look. He's picking the ball up here unopposed. Potentially Casemiro might see it. But if he can get into those channels behind Marcelo, running at Ramos, as good as a player as he is in terms of personality and leadership, rash, not as quick as he was, slightly immobile, that's the way in. That's the Achilles heel in this Real Madrid team, has been for the last 2, 3, 4 years. That partnership between Marcelo and Ramos, getting into those enough possession and getting players into that area of the pitch. And Liverpool have one of the best players in the world, the most potent attacking threats operating in that area of the pitch at the moment, supported by an outstanding young fullback. Mm. If they can get enough possession, I don't mean dominate possession, and get him in possession in these areas of the pitch, in this diamond system from Madrid, Liverpool are going to have a lot of joy. And that's the fascination for me, how Zidane will choose to play.